Now we will initiate the session with discussion of Sharda ma'am and Harsh sir on the topic future activities under OMRISE. Now I will request sir and ma'am to kindly take over the seat on the stage.
So, as you are all aware, this is the second conference of the OMRISE series. So, here we would like to discuss about what we can do to make the experience of the audience and the knowledge dissemination and the overall impact, whatever we intended at the time of deciding to organize this conference, how to make it better, and what other activities can be done. So, I would like to request Sharda ji, she could throw some light on how she has felt in this conference and what we can do for that.
Well, I really enjoyed the conference. The sequence of the speeches were very good. If we see the theme yesterday, we were talking about the broader picture of integrating certification. We moved on to connect to different business contexts. And yesterday we couldn't finish that session on harmonizing intelligence. But if you see, I think it was best to do it this morning because many other paper presentations were on technology. So you may say there was a kind of a natural flow. First day, more on organizational behavior, humanness, and the second day, maybe much more deep into technology. There is some stress when you see people have to present in 10 minutes or 7 minutes. So how to solve that in the future? Do we have to solve it or do we have to prepare it differently? I must say, 10 minutes is okay. I have been going to conferences. Academy of Management conference is in management the top conference, and it's very hard to get into it because 10,000 people come, and about 20,000 people from every corner of the world submit their paper, and 50% or 40% in some fields got acceptance. What do they do? How many days? We have 5 days, and so not everyone is in one place. Of course, there are different divisions. So maybe if we have too many papers, some thing can be that we have two parallel sessions. Though I like this format much more. There we have, even if you are a full professor or assistant, 10 minutes. And in some sessions we have symposia of 5 minutes. So I don't think a number of minutes is a point. But the only thing there we have some more preparation. We see up front the abstracts and papers. So you can read before you go to the session what it is about. And then you can come up with some questions. So, and usually that gives some kind of more follow-up discussion. Like now, it's a pity that those who present, they don't get the chance to interact much also. And their new ideas can come. So if we start earlier with the preparation and really try to next time be concrete with, okay, this is the final date of submission of abstract, and maybe it is a big step to immediately go to a paper, but we can say, not a short abstract, but try to at least talk about your research question and your research methodology and your abstract much more elaborated than what we did now. Then we can also give a lot of feedback. For me, now, for example, I've done so many types of research, it's not easy to give everyone feedback on how to improve your research. Overall, I would say what I've seen, two things are a bit lacking or can be improved in the papers. One is, I haven't seen anyone really addressing this is my research question. I've seen objectives, or these are the aims I want to achieve, or sometimes this is happening, this is the context. But, you know, research is trying to find a way of looking a few to something which you can also grasp. Even if the broader team is there, in the research context, you need to bring it back to some focus. And that focus is very much required. And what is that part of the focus? That is the research question. And in the research question, you need to say or think in terms of what is the dependent variable, what is it I'm looking at, and from which perspective you want to look at, amongst what type of people are you going to look at, in what time frame. So those kinds of restrictions, by building that, you will focus. And then for the for the person who is receiving this presentation, it's easy. Then 10 minutes is fine. Then you can focus and follow it. The second thing that was a bit missing sometimes was the research methodology. We tend to say what we have done, like we have collected 150 data points or some of these things. We did some questionnaire here and there, but what is the research methodology is important. And I was happy to see especially many of the faculties here trying to look at, is there a Indian or Bharati perspective to that research methodology? And that's a very interesting thing, and very interesting part of you know, elaborating more, because I don't think many of us know how to connect that information to what we have been taught in the more mainstream research books. So how to connect that part, that would be very interesting. I was very much positive, or it gave me a very positive feeling to see the big improvement compared to last year in the papers, in the focus of, you know, what type of literature are we using. And actually, I saw many of you were very proud using your Bharatiya concepts. And that was so good, because I have been learning also due to all these presentations. And why is it important? Because as we said in integrative intelligence, it's so much context specific. So if you don't look at the context and just want to use some theories, even for us in the Netherlands, many theories that we are using are developed in US, because their majority of the research is happening. So also to my students, I always say, try to see, is it something you can use in your context? Or do you need to adapt here and there? Or at least say something about it. Mm-hmm. So, okay, we have then always this tendency, okay, are there Dutch you know, articles available to refer at? But usually that's not happening, because the majority of the articles are written in English also by Dutch scholars. But at least that reflection has to happen somehow. And so if you try to bring that in such a context, which itself is a diverse context, what may work in Mumbai may not work here. So those kinds of reflections are very much important, I think. We have not listened to students' presentations, and I hope you know, to get the kind of case studies that we have been talking about last time. One of my calls was, I said, if we can look at cases. See, it's very interesting, a good sort of the case, and more interesting that it is being applied in different contexts, and recently we are trying to apply it or bring it to India. But there are so many other cases here which are interesting. And if you would like to put this lens and see how much that is you know, applicable for Indian cases, or like Professor Rajanji said, you know, validate, because what I'm doing, it's a long path. Many of these cases are required to validate, you know, if the things that we are developing, these concepts, are valid in all these different contexts. So that could be one of the things that we do in the future conference, much more. That could be one thing that we say, you know, maybe one day part all case presentations. And case presentations could be like we invite people from practice. So I was very happy to have someone like Radhaji here. coming from practice, also having that theoretical background. And, you know, these are the kind of talks that enrich you, because it's not only about theory, but also, you know, how to make that useful. And I think the management study is the place to do that, because with only theories or only persons, you know, having some kind of opinion and talking about their opinions, which are sometimes very inspiring. But I would like to have this good balance, okay? Because it should inspire you to apply those things in your own context. What is next that we want to do? Last time we were thinking of, is the quality good enough to work on a paper or a series of papers for a journal or a book? Sometimes you need four of these conferences to have really good material to make a book or a special issue. It's not only here. I have been doing conferences also internationally. So in the past, what we did is after two conferences, we see, okay, is there something, some direction to have a theme which we propose to a journal, and then also see what are the things missing which we could not cover in a conference, and are there experts in the world who we can invite to submit. There are two kinds of outlets. We can think of books, we can think of journal, and we have been talking already to two journals, editors, and there is a process of publication, so whatever we propose, it will be in 2019 or late 2019 available. So we need to see. But I was recently in IIM Ahmedabad for a lecture, and I saw there are some types of books there. And one book was their own material of cases. I think there was a book with 100 cases which faculty members or students worked on. So we don't need to immediately go to a journal. We can say, okay, so we can do a special issue with some of the papers presented here and some others whom we will invite. But one step could be where we engage students is to have cases, and with this kind of paradigm that we are proposing, collect cases. We can make templates, we can develop templates and say, okay, these are the things that we are missing. And if it's fitting in one of or the courses, we can see. And it could be an idea to have four or five of you working on one case. And those cases can be put then in such a booklet, which maybe a faculty can use. And later on, after a few sessions of using that case, we can improve it and use it in a book which other universities or internationally can be used. But this whole thing is always a work in progress, of course. So that's those are my first thoughts.
Thank you very much, Professor Shardaji. I think we really appreciate the fact that you have put in the positives out of this conference and also mentioned that what are those things that can be improved. I think all of us would further agree and agree that the first OMRISE conference that we did, we have made a lot of improvisation in the terms of the overall feel that one gets, the overall impact that this conference is likely to have. I think we are going quite in the right direction. And I also appreciate her view that we have to move gradually. It is a step-by-step approach and different things. We can have some of the case studies papers, as she is mentioning, the form of our own in-house publication. And apart from that, we have some time. So though all those who have presented papers, if they can improve it more, improve on the quality that can be the one that can be accepted, or even going beyond the expectations of the journal editors, and then I think that will be a good thing for everyone, for you all individually who have presented the papers, and of course those who will be presenting now, and also those who do it in the future. That is one thing. So in this conference, as far as the contents are concerned, we have covered up the contents in about you can say roughly about 1.5 days to 2 days, as we were discussing just minutes before, what usually people would have covered in 3 days. So on the efficiency frontier, already, you know, we have outperformed. And each and every one here, the volunteers, all those who are involved, you know, they deserve the credit for that. Yes. And one more thing we can do is that we can think about the run-up for the next conference. And first of all, as far as this conference is concerned, I think some portion we could record the video, or we have the papers, text and presentations are there. So I would like to propose over here that what we can do is that maybe after a month or so, we organize a program over here in Banasthali, in which we invite the students, that based on the different contents presented by the different speakers, what are their views. Maybe we can have 10 or 12 presentations in a day, and people can put in their views, and that can be a learning. And then we can do one more program that can be one next step to it, maybe in the next semester. So that also forms a kind of run-up for the next, that is the third conference that we would be, of course, be doing. One more thing I would like to mention over here, that very recently we had submitted a proposal to the Confederation of Indian Industries, and they have a body called as the National Foundation of Corporate Governance. So they have recognized Banasthali as a National Center for Corporate Governance. And after getting that, they have given the NCCG to a few more, and even those who are not the NCCG, they had the CII offered them that if they would like to organize some conference, they can give the applications, give the details and all. We also submitted one. So they have approved about 3 or 4 conferences out of total 30 applications. And they were all, you know, I mean, quite, you can say, the leaders in their own area. And there were central universities, private universities, deemed universities and others. So out of 30, they have chosen 4, and Banasthali is also one of them. So we have planned that we will do a conference on corporate governance somewhere in August. And there, one thing we can keep is that we can, of course, showcase the OMRISE in this and present the Budzog governance model as well. So I think next couple of weeks, we would have some dates also with us, with discussing with the relevant people over here. And so that can be one thing, that okay, the next OMRISE conference is a little away, of course, about a year, but before that there can be one more activity in this form, and there will be people in the Indian industry and all, they will also come to know about all this. So I think that that would be the immediate next thing that we can do. That would be helpful. But of course, apart from that, many more things further we can do, and we can discuss over. Something else comes to your mind, what we can do more?
I think we have to listen, of course, to the Patanjali case, but working in groups to on cases, that would be one thing to really you know, implement in the coming time. I would just like to say that I'm very happy everything went so well, and Ankuji has been organizing on the back, Puniji has been organizing here to help everyone, you know, to have a good flow. But a lot has been done by all the volunteers, and I would like to really give them a big applause. Because this is not your daily work, and it has been done in a very professional way. So usually if you go to other conferences, there are professional people at the back organizing this, and this was self-managed, and it was very good to see that happening.
And of course, an applause for the audience, all of you as well. Usually what we find is that when we have the last session of the conference, the attendance is just 10 to 15%. But I think only 10 to 15% are not here. So it's the other way around. over here. So that's also great. And I think, you know, I understand that for many of you, maybe there may be many things you may not be able to comprehend. Some of you have told me that these were the things you have learned and all. So we really appreciate. But apart from that, the books and all that, a copy of the book that we have given to the various speakers, we will have a good number of copies in our library. So you can read them and we will have further discussions and all. And so that you can slowly absorb and the many more things that were the part of this conference. Will it be appropriate? We can ask them if they would like. So if someone would like to share some feedback or someone would like to tell us how the things can be better and or how we can increase the impact of OMRISE, of course, requesting everyone over here. So please do. From the faculty members or anyone would like to.
In the last conference, we also mentioned this, but maybe this conference also, I should mention this, that we should allow papers in the native language. If someone wants to give a paper in Hindi or Bengali or Punjabi, or, and we should find out a way in which the audience who is not following that language, maybe the paper presenter can give it translation beforehand in printed form to the audience who doesn't understand that language. But the presenter should be able to give the language of his or her choice. So that is one area that where we can do some innovation and where...